Hello, I'm Juan Davies, Chief Creative Officer at KCTM PBS SoCal, and I'm joined by the newsroom of KPCC and LAist on a daily reporter roundup. How is everyone?
Great. Not bad, considering.
Jill Replogol, who's sitting in today for Adrian Hill, welcome.
Thank you.
Jackie, you have been reporting on a Pasadena nursing home that had to be evacuated last night. What are the details?
Yeah, all 63 residents of the Golden Cross Healthcare Facility in Pasadena were evacuated, like you said, to other area nursing homes. Officials with the Pasadena Health Department told me that the nursing home simply wasn't taking care of their residents. They were tipped off by a medical team with the National Guard, who's been working at the nursing home since April as part of the state's COVID-19 response. The National Guard workers reported that there was substandard care, and inspectors found that residents weren't being fed or given water in some cases. Luckily, none of the people evacuated needed to be hospitalized. The city's coronavirus dashboard shows that 72 residents and 32 staff members at Golden Cross Healthcare have contracted COVID-19, and 8 people have died. It's unclear if any of those deaths are due to that inadequate care. That may come to light during the criminal investigation that was launched yesterday by the state attorney general's office.
LA County released the results of its latest homeless count this morning. They are not good. Matt Tinoco has been covering homelessness for us for the last several years and can put it in some context.
So now the number is 66,433. That's a 13% increase from last year. And that number is for all of Los Angeles County. And it's supposed to include anyone in a homeless shelter or who's sleeping somewhere not fit for human habitation, like a car or a tent. Last year, though, we saw an increase basically about the same percentage as this year from the year before that one, too. Once again, senior homelessness is up, this time another 20%. That is also now a consistent trend over the last several years. And just like last year, though, the core problem is just more people falling into homelessness, what's called inflow. This year's demographers with LASA, the Homeless Services Authority that did the count, determined that inflow over the last year actually increased by 50% from the year before. Without reducing the number of people falling into homelessness, there's no way that we're going to be able to get everybody off the street.
Many businesses in LA County were allowed to reopen today for the first time in months. Emily Guerin is going to tell us about some of those businesses and the rules that they have to follow.
So the businesses that can reopen today include gyms, movie theaters, zoos, museums, and aquariums, among other things. Universally in LA County, all employees and customers have to wear masks and practice social distancing, but there's a lot of industry-specific guidelines. So for example, museums can't offer group tours, and they have to direct people through the galleries in a one-way direction. And at the gym, you don't have to wear a mask while you're exercising, but you do the rest of the time. And certain high-contact activities are still not allowed, like spa treatments or basketball. Also, no hot yoga. Classes above 100 degrees are discouraged. And if you go to the movies this weekend, expect to be surrounded by a lot of empty chairs and forget about sneaking out for a sip of water because water fountains will be turned off.
Finally, obviously it's been a tough few weeks and months for a lot of us. Eric Galindo wrote an essay on his recent effort at self-care.
Yeah, it's been a rough few months, you know, COVID and then George Floyd and the protests and the way officials reacted to the protests. It just kind of really broke me, and I had to get out of town. And I wound up in this little town called Julian. It's a little apple orchard town. I went there to get away from all this. And when I got there, I found out that the town was named after a former Confederate soldier named Mike Julian, who really didn't have anything to do with the town being founded. He was just like the first one there. The guy who should really get the credit is a free black man named Fred Coleman. He was a cattleman, and he found gold in a creek and began the first and only San Diego gold rush. And he was the big part of why San Diego exists. In any case, though, like, I was able to enjoy myself and reset myself. And I think it's important to practice self-care and try to be better for yourself, like treat yourself nicely sometimes.
Thank you, Eric. And thank you all at the KPCC and LA's newsroom. And thank you for tuning in. Take care of yourself, your health, your neighbor, and we will see you on Monday.